During the last year, 2013, in the club, and it's important for you, if you work in the youth house, if you work with the youth academy, or if you work in the first team, to understand the club as a whole. You have to understand, you have to reflect of core values and also in the way that we work. It will occur during 2014, a lot of strange moments, and it will be different. It will be totally different for some of you. Some of you have been in the club for a while, know that these things will come. We will, during the 2014, we will start up an international academy for football, where we, during next week, will go to North Africa and to Libya, and in Libya we will select 60 youth players in the age group of 18 to 20, and they will start the first contingent of the International Academy. And they will be then footballers selected from the whole country, from the 16 top clubs, and also from the second division and from the national teams. They will be here 9 months until end of November. This is the first of its kind in the world, and we are very proud in the club to have the opportunity. I've been over Libya a couple of times, and it is a fantastic country with a great history. And actually they have a good setup of football. They host the African Championship in 2017. They are now working towards develop sports and youth in the country. And it is quite interesting that a club up in the mountains in the middle of Sweden is signing the documents with the government of Libya. And we can sometimes ask ourselves if everything is right in the head and minds of us, ourselves. But the challenge is unbelievable and fantastic. And I believe that in Tripoli, which is the biggest city, the capital, I think Östersund is more well known than Sweden itself in the capital at these days. Last time I was there, two times ago, some service with Facebook or whatever, it was collapsed after an interview in a TV station in a club there. The national team is ranked 59 in the world. And before the revolution, one of the clubs was ranked 32 in the world. So they played football for a long time. Thing is that during the Gaddafi era of 42 years, they were not allowed to go abroad to express their football. So therefore, it would be an exciting time. We have signed a 5-year contract with them. We start out with 60, what I call kids, but they are in your age, some of you, and next year they will be 250. If everything would go smooth, we would have maybe introduce other sports in that international academy. And we should not exclude that other countries will follow in the path of this international academy, which we hopefully will be very, very proud of. And some new faces here will be heavily involved, and management of the club and their coaches and so on, both in youth and the first team, will be involved. But there will be their own setup of coaches and managers. And the only thing that we will and are very keen on is that our philosophy of football will be the leading point in the education there. It will also be the English computer information technology skills, and also have small courses, UEFA, first level and first aid and so on and so on. So that's a new challenge for the club, which of course you will notice. And I think it is before they are here and all the questions will be raised around it. I think it is proper that you've got information first hand of it. So the club is developing and changing the organization, and also of course the financial basis for running the club is very, very important, and we are nowadays working very hard in that part so that we can create the resources for today's challenge and tomorrow's challenge. And also we know where we are, and we have to think differently also than to create possibilities and chances of income. And to get income you have to work very hard, and we are very happy also for that, that we can start up this international academy, which we foresee that can be quite interesting in the years to come. So this is just a small piece of things that we believe that we do a little bit differently than others. Hopefully if we work hard, we will get the success we want. And the Culture Academy, which also starts up today, we have based three of our cultural coaches in this building. So if you have any question or want any assist or help in that, you can always go here and find them. They will be based here, and we also have Karin, who is based down in Stockholm. And for the next challenge, which will have the crescendo in late August, beginning of March, we will then have a massive art renaissance in Storsjö Theatre, and every one of us will create a piece of art that will go under an auction, and all the money will go to charity. But it will be expressions of yourself, your art course that you will go through this year, who will be expressed on paper. And that's a very, very strong thing to express yourself into a painting, and everybody will be able to go and look at that, and you will also be told to write a small note about what it is and why. To put also your expressions and feelings into words together with your painting. And we then have a special art coach, a lady, regionally here, and I think also nationally. She's a very famous person, Kajsa Tuva Henriksson, or Werner, that is his name. She will be the art coach, and it will be moments for you to be educated in different styles of painting, and you will also see and learn a lot about different expressions in painting through the local galleries, through the Jamtling, and we will also, when we are on our travels, we will book time to go to the famous galleries and museums in Stockholm, in Uppsala, and down in Skåne, if they have anyone in Skåne, but at least we have in the capital. We will take our time to explore Sweden through our travels, which are long and sometimes boring, through the museums and galleries, so that you will pick up all the inspiration you can get there, and also through the education you will get, and slowly you will form up your own identity on painting. And that will be in this exhibition for 2 weeks, and then of course the auction will be a success. I foresee many thousands who will come here and see this, and just as last time. This is very, very important. Because if we can win that battle over ourselves and over the fear to show our paintings in public and let them be auctioned, I think we will continue. In that time, August, September, we will continue on our winning path. Because in the end of the day, everything we do to win football matches. And that's the absolutely most important thing of all. To win the battle on the day when we start our campaign. Then after that game, the most important is next game. And all the preparation and all the focus is on winning that game. And to be winners in the end of the day of everything. Because we cannot compromise with winning. We can have discussions and we can compromise with a lot of things in life. But in the football club, in Östersund Football Club, we cannot compromise with winning the next game. Because if we start to think that, we have already put a stamp that we are losers. So, whatever you do during this trip, through the book, through the paintings, everything we do, steps
towards winning next game. And this is highly modest. We don't set up goals in table that we should be at least number 6. We should avoid being number 14. Yeah, we are very happy if we are second. That's a mentality that we have to get rid of. And the old ones have got a touch of this, and a sense of this, and for you new ones, you have to know that we are very serious when it's coming to winning. And it is not allowed to not be involved in the courses of culture. It is as important as a training, and many trainings. And you will have a lot of trainings in this painting. It will start up after we have released the book. We have a away game, as you know, the first one, and our two home games. During that exciting period, we will go into the mystery of the painting. Every moment in the club is to be better every day. To work very, very hard. To laugh a lot. To be friendly. That's the key things to work together. And on the match day, everybody knows the rule. We're winning the game. Gaffer, backroom staff, all the preparations to help you. When you're there, you're alone. Let the same loneliness that you will feel when you put your painting up in before the Renaissance. You're alone there with your painting. You have to stand for that. Let the same when you go out to the pitch. It is your decision, and you have the ball. You cannot turn around to your girlfriend or your mother or your gaffer or somebody else. You have to prepare for that. So if you have problem with painting, or to be involved in our cultural academy, then you have to go to the gaffer very, very soon. Because then we have a problem. If Gaffer sees there is a big problem, then he has to come to me, and then you have a big problem. Then you have a big problem. But as I've got to learn you as individuals, I know you hopefully so good as at this moment that I know that. You see the challenge in this, and after the applause from the release of the book, we will take on the new challenge under the cultural coaches and Kaiser Trivon. And don't underestimate her, because she looks very nice and very friendly, but she's very, very tough. And you will, through her, explore a new side of yourself. So that is the expectation and the activities in the Cultural Academy. And of course, as you understand, after that we have had the Renaissance, it's not a long time before you get a new challenge. And that will continue. And hopefully, everything builds on. So by that, I am happy to then announce that we have started the 2014 campaign. And if you have any issues or questions or whatever,
around this, you are always welcome to talk to the management or of course to me too. I'm an involved chairman.
If you are new here, I will be around and you will see me in training in other places.
So by that, I hope that you continue the hard training and the hard work, and we will see each other hopefully in the release of the book and in the games and training and start of the art. So take it easy outside because it's very, very slippery and we don't want any injury because injury players doesn't score any goals. So take care out there and all the best. Thank you.